Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And
with your spirit. Welcome you to Mass this morning. As it's a ferial day, we can have a votive Mass, and as June is dedicated to the Sacred Heart, we'll have a votive Mass of the Sacred Heart ahead of the feast day next Friday. So the whole of the month of June dedicated to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Our Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Nora Eileen Moran. And after Mass, we have the burial of ashes of Charlene Cassandra. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my thoughts, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conformed to his image, we may merit to share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever.
Clapped their hands and shouted, "Long live the King!" smashed his altars and his images and killed Matan, the priest of Baal, in front of the altars. The priest posted images to guard the temple of the Lord. All the country people were delighted, and the city made no move. And they put Ataliah to death in the royal palace. The word of the Lord. The Lord has chosen Zion. He has desired it for his dwelling. The Lord has chosen Zion. He has desired it for his dwelling. The Lord swore an oath to David. He will not go back on his word. A son, the fruit of your body, will I set upon your throne. The Lord has chosen Zion. He has desired it for his dwelling. If they keep my covenant in truth, and my laws that I have taught them, their sons also shall rule on their throne from age to age. The Lord has chosen Zion. He has desired it for his dwelling. For the Lord has chosen Zion. He has desired it for his dwelling. This is my resting place forever. Here have I chosen to live. The Lord has chosen Zion. He has desired it for his dwelling. There the stock of David will flourish. I will prepare a land for my anointed. I will cover his enemies with shame, but on him my crown shall shine. The Lord has chosen Zion. He has desired it for his dwelling.
The lamp of the body is the eye. It follows as if your eye is sand. Your whole body will be filled with light. But if your eye is diseased, your whole body will be all darkness. If then the light inside you is darkness, what darkness that will be. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Although there is only one God, there are plenty of idols demanding our attention. We would be well advised to start weaning ourselves off such practices or risk a cleansing not of our own making. But can I just say it's far too hot to be going out and destroying any pagan temples today and putting any rogue kings and queens to death. So please don't do that today. It's too hot, and we're going to really need to hear this. But we do need to deal with these idols, because we can see the consequences of the Old Testament. The Northern Kingdom was swept away by its neighbouring powers because they did not put their trust and fidelity in God. The Southern Kingdom, there was a remnant surviving, but they too are not immune from invading powers, and they are promised the Messiah, the Anointed One, a descendant of King David, who would provide a providential rescue. that their desire for a king was risky, because they would get good kings and they would get bad kings. As we know, power corrupts those with a predilection to greed. And so those jubilee years that we hear about in the Old Testament, they're meant to be a resetting of the proper due order, a time for rest, a time for redemption, a time for deliverance. From time to time, the church gives us jubilee years. We had usually get them every 25 years. Sometimes they pass us by because we're so busy. We forget to take that time for reset, for rest, for redemption, for deliverance. But we need them because the covenant with the Lord always can be better celebrated. We can always renew our faith. We can always recommit ourselves to God. And in one way, the gospel is proposing a question. You know, where is our treasure? What is important to us? Where do our priorities lie? Every treasure in the form of an earthly good, whether it's wealth, whether it's property, they're going to be a constant source of worry for us, because there's always that risk that they're going to be lost or taken from us or damaged beyond repair. Putting our faith in material things is a form of idol worship. It can never lead to salvation. As they say, there are no pockets in a shroud. You cannot take it with you. Our treasure exists in bearing fruit, fruit that will last. Our good deeds go with us. Our reward will be great in heaven. And one of my favourite funeral readings is actually very short. It's just one verse. And no, I don't like it because it's short. It's very profound. I, John, heard a voice from heaven say to me, write down, happy are those who die in the Lord. Happy indeed, the Spirit says. Now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruits of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise of the glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, Father of mercies, who because of the great love with which you loved us, with untold goodness gave us your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with him, we may offer you worthy homage. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up our hearts. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the Church's sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Saviour, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection. Until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants Noah, Ayu, Moran, and Charlene, Cassandra, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son and the death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
In and with heaven and in heaven, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, power, and the glory of your church, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
So shortly after Mass, we have the burial of ashes of Charlene Cassandra. Eternal rest shall come to her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. Just a reminder, tomorrow is our second day of First Holy Communions, so there's no Mass here at 10 o'clock on Saturday because the First Holy Communion Mass takes precedence and it's 12 noon at St. Martha's, although the church will be open during the day on Saturday for private prayer. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.